Hello everyone, this is Eddie the Magic Monk. Welcome to another tutorial on matrices. Today we're going to talk about how to use Gaussian elimination to solve a system of simultaneous equations with three variables. So you can see here I have three equations and they all involve the variables a, b, and c. So 2a plus 3b minus 4c equals negative 5 and so on. And the first thing you've got to do is rewrite this system of equations as a matrix equation. So now I have the coefficient of each of these variables written inside the first matrix. A, B, and C, which are the variables written inside the second matrix. And the result on the right hand side written in the resulting matrix. Okay, once you have done that, then the next step is to write an augmented matrix, which means a matrix without the variable matrix. So let's write 2, 3, negative 4, 5, negative 1, 2, negative 2, negative 2, 3, a straight vertical line down the middle, and then negative 5, 15, 3. Okay, so from here, whatever we do, we have to do to the whole row of the matrix. Okay, of this augmented matrix. And the goal is to get the numbers below the leading diagonal. So this is the leading diagonal. The goal is to get the numbers below it to zero. And we're going to start with this number here, try to get it down to zero. And then we're going to do this number, and then we do this number. All right, so basically we start in the bottom left. We go upwards until we hit the leading diagonal, then we go to the next column, starting from the bottom. Okay, so let's do, so let's make this row 1, row 2, and row 3. And the first thing I'm going to do is get row 3 plus row 1. So when we are working on row 3, you can just copy all the other rows down as they are. So I'm copying all of these other rows down. And then row 3 plus row 1. So negative 2 plus 2 is 0. Negative 2 plus 3 is 1. 3 plus negative 4 is negative 1. 3 plus negative 5 is negative 2. So now I have a 0 down the bottom left hand corner, so I have completed step 1. Step 2, I'm going to try and make this 5 turn into a 0. Alright, so let's try 2 times row 2. So this is row 2. 2 times row 2 minus 5 times row 1. Okay, so this is row 1 and this is row 2, and we're going to multiply each of these numbers in row 2 by 2, and then we're going to take their corresponding element in row 1 times by 5. So let's try that. So I'm just going to write 5 by row 1 first. So 2 by 5 is 10, 3 by 5 is 15, negative 4 by 5 is negative 20, negative 5 by 5 is negative 25. Okay, and then what I'm going to do is row 2 by 2, so I have 10, negative 2, 4, 30, and then row 3, I'm not doing anything, so copy it down. Okay, so now I'm going to get the second row minus the first row. So 10 minus 10 is equal to 0. Negative 2 minus 15 is negative 2 minus 15, negative 17. 4 minus negative 20 is 4 plus 20, which is 24. And 30 minus negative 25 is 30 plus 25, which is 55. Okay, so now I'm going to copy down row 1 as it was before I made any changes to it, because I only make changes to one row at a time. So I have 0, 1, negative 1, negative 2. Okay, so this is the result from doing 2 times row 2 minus 5 times row 1. Right, this is 2 times row 2 and this is 5 times row 1. So this is a result after step 2, and now we want this last number here to be 0. So let's try. So this is row 3 and this is row 2. Let's try 17 row 3 plus row 2. Okay, so let's write down what 17 row 3 is. So zero, negative 17, 24, 55. 17 row 3 becomes 0, 17, negative 17, negative 34. So 17 row 3 plus row 2. So that's 17 row 3, that's row 2. So then this becomes, so row 2 doesn't change. So this then becomes 0, 17 plus negative 17 is 0, negative 17 plus 24 is 7, and negative 34 plus 55 is 21. Okay, now we have completed our goal. That is, we've got all the numbers below the leading diagonal to turn into zeros. Now, some people will say that you need to change the top three numbers to zero as well, but you can actually just get the answers from here. So let's just do that. So let's write out the matrices again in full form, not augmented form. So ABC equals negative 5, 55, 21. Okay, and let's write out the multiplications from the bottom row. So I have the bottom row times by ABC is equal to 21. So 0A plus 0B plus 7C equals 21. So you don't need to write this at the front. So 7C equals 21. C equals 21 over 7, which is 3. Okay, so since C is 3, I can now substitute 3 into where C is. So I can just rub this out and change it to 3. Okay, actually I still write C equals, just so people don't get confused. So C equals 3. So now let's do the second row here. So we have 0A minus 17B plus 24 times 3 is equal to 55. All right, second row times first column equals second row first column. So now we have negative 17B plus whatever this is, 72 equals 55. Negative 17B equals 55 minus 72, which is negative 17. So negative 17B equals negative 17. B equals 1. Okay, so now we found B is equal to 1. And now let's just do the last remaining line. So it's 2 times 3, sorry, 2, 3, negative 4 times ABC equals negative 5. So let's write it over here. So 2A plus 3B minus 4C equals negative 5. B is equal to 1. C is equal to 3. So 2A plus 3 minus 12 is equal to negative 5. 2A equals negative 5 plus 12 minus 3. 2A equals minus 8 plus 12, so that is 4, and A is equal to 2. So these are our solutions. Our solution is A equals 2, B equals 1, and C equals 3. Okay, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.